Hello class 10, this is the final and the last part of your lesson, a math tea party. Now before I start with today's class, I want to give you a brief recapitulation of what we have done in our story. Now what is it? We see that there are three characters, March Hare, Dormouse, Hatter, and we have got Alice separately, in total four. Now all of them are there and they discuss about time, they discuss about a riddle answer to which none of them knows, and then they ask finally the Dormouse to tell a story, and the Dormouse starts telling a story regarding three sisters. What do? All the three sisters, they live inside the well, and what do they live upon? They live upon treacle, that is good. Now what happened after that? We shall continue with today's class. Take some more tea, the March Hare said to Alice, very earnestly. So the March Hare asked Alice to take some more tea. I had nothing yet, Alice replied in an offended tone. So I can't take more. I did not have only anything, how can I take anything more? You mean you can't take less, said the Hatter. So the Hatter said, take some more means you cannot take something less. It's very easy to take more than nothing. So it's very easy to take more than having nothing. Nobody asked your opinion, said Alice. So Alice said, nobody has asked for your opinion. Who's making personal remarks now? The Hatter asked triumphantly. So the Hatter asked, who's making these personal remarks? Alice did not quite know what to say to this. So she helped herself to some tea, bread and butter. She did not know what to say. So she had some tea, bread, butter. And then questioned, why did they live at the bottom of a well? So why did they live at the bottom of the well? The Dormouse again took a minute or two to think about it and said, it was a treacle. Okay? Treacle well means it was a well with that good. Treacle. There's no such thing. There cannot be a well which is full of treacle. Alice was beginning very angrily, but the Hatter and the March Hare went, shh, said the Dormouse sulking, and remarked, if you can't be civil, you'd better finish the story for yourself. If you do not let me finish, then why don't you tell the story on your own? No, please go on. You please continue, said Alice very humbly. I won't interrupt you again. I promise I'm not going to interrupt you again. I dare say there are many, maybe one. I just said, maybe there is one. One indeed, said the Dormouse indignantly. However, he consented to go on. He wanted to go on. And so, these three little sisters, they were learning to draw. So they were learning to draw. What did they draw? Said Alice, quite forgetting her promise. Alice promised that she is not going to question, but she completely forgot her promise and she is questioning. I want a clean cup, interrupted the Hatter. So then let's all move on. One place only. So the Hatter said, I want a clean cup. Let's do one thing. Let all of us move on one seat to another. Like one over here. Suppose I'm over here. Somebody is sitting over there. I'll move to that somebody's place. And here who is sitting will come and shift to my place. So what did they do? He moved on as he spoke. The Dormouse followed him. The March Hare moved into the Dormouse's place. So the March Hare, he moved into the Dormouse's place. Alice, rather unwillingly, took the place of the March Hare. Alice took the place of the March Hare. The Hatter was the only one who got any advantage from the change. So the Hatter was the only one who hasn't got any advantage. Alice was a good deal worse than before, as the March Hare had just upset the milk jug into his hand. So Alice was not feeling good. Why? Because the March Hare, he had overturned the milk jug into his plate. Alice did not wish to offend the Dormouse again. So she began cautiously, but I don't understand where did they draw the triangle from? No, she is asking. Draw means like you draw water from the well, like that. So where did they draw the triangle from? You can draw water from the water well, said the hatter. So I should think you could draw triangle out of the triangle well. If you can draw water from the water well, you can definitely draw triangle from the triangle well. How stupid. But they were in the well, Alice said to the dormouse, not choosing to notice this last one. Of course they were, but they were themselves in the well. Being in the well, how can they themselves draw anything? Well, in this answer so confused poor Alice that she let the dormouse go on for some time without interrupting. This made her so confused that she kept quiet for a moment to allow the dormouse to continue his story. They were learning to draw. The dormouse went on, yawning, rubbing its eyes, for it was getting very sleepy. They drew all manner of things, everything that begins with an M. Why with an M? Why it begin with M? Why did they have to take up anything that began with M? Why not? Said the marshal. So marshal said, why they can't take? Alice was silent. The dormouse had closed its eyes by this time and was going off into a doze. So he was so drowsy, he wanted to fall asleep. But on being pinched by the hatter, it woke up again. Somebody pinched him and he woke up again and went on. That begins with an M, such as mouse traps, moon, memory, muchness. You know, say things. Much of muchness. So you say that things like M, moon, then mouse, then memory, muchness, very much. So muchness, more than much. Did you ever see thing drawing of a muchness? So do you think it's easy? Have you seen anyone drawing muchness? Really, now you ask me. So you are asking me a question now. You will allow me to answer? Very much confused. I don't think so. I don't think. Then you shouldn't. Then don't have to talk. This piece of rudeness was more than Alice could bear. This was something that he could bear. She got up in great disgust and walked. So this made her very much upset. She got up and she wanted to walk off from that place. The dormouse fell asleep. The dormouse instantly fell asleep. And neither of the others took least notice of her going, though she looked back once or twice. Though she looked back once or twice, they were not very interested. The last time she saw them, they were trying to put the dormouse into the teaspoon. So the last time she saw them, she found them putting the dormouse into the teaspoon. At any rate, I'll never go there. So she decided at any rate, she's not going to go there, said Alice as she picked her way through the woods. It's the stupidest tea party I've ever was it in my life. It was the stupidest tea party I've ever come across in my life. So here, obviously Alice was sad at last. Story by the dormouse is very important. And what story? That the three sisters lived on triangle. This part is very important. So students, along with this, you will get one PDF attached. Kindly write it in your classroom copy. Hope you have enjoyed the story and the class. Thank you so much.